You got the little. It concerns me that you say the screening people are unwilling to go back on anything. Because surely the whole purpose in any of these things is to work on the up-to-date information. Well, and it doesn't mean their first decision wasn't right at the time.
No.
But they should be willing to review these things.
We entirely agree with that. And it's a bit of a puzzle to us why, when we go to meetings, if you talk to neonatal doctors, etc., everyone agrees that it would be sensible for us to introduce this. But there seems to be a sort of administrative block in the centre, which keeps saying there aren't any randomised trials. We need evidence from the UK. Well, no, neither of those things seem to us to be relevant anymore, considering the evidence that we've got from all these other countries. And the other issue is we have actually, Jane and I were involved in 7 or 8 years ago, applications for government funding to do a prospective randomised trial, which would require a very large number of women to take part. But anyway, it would have cost several million pounds and it was never funded. So we're in the situation where we would be happy to support research if it resulted in us getting to the right conclusion, which we're sure it would. The problem is it's expensive to do research and we can't get the money for it.
We might as well use other people's research.
Correct, absolutely. I mean, and I suspect that if we put in an application for to do a study now, it will be turned down on the basis that we already know the answer. So we're in a catch-22 on that.